Hello everyone, welcome to JCE Connect. So in this session, we'll start with the inspection and test plan in the quality of the construction. So here, in general, we can discuss about inspection and test plan. So that inspection, which is defined as an organized examination or formal evaluation exercise. So that's nothing but you'll be having several activities since from starting till end. So here each and every activities has to be examined with respect to quality aspects. Okay, so it's like what we need to keep an eye on those activities, that whether they are following quality aspects during the execution parts or not. So it's like a formal evaluation exercise, means we should be continuously monitoring those activities with respect to work orders as well as with respect to the material specifications, which one they are using in that activity. And so here inspection and test plans are the integral part of the quality system. So when you have adopted this inspection as well as the test, then only you can achieve the quality. Okay, it's like what these two terms, that is inspection as well as the test plan, are a major part of this quality. Okay, you have to be stick with this inspection part as well as the test plan part. And then third point, that is inspection and test, which are the basic activities used in the management, whether approaches detection or prevention based. So here inspection and test plans, these two activities which are used in two different approaches, first one detection and second one is prevention. So detection in the sense where exactly we have made the mistake, that one we need to identify and we need to make that one correct before for the final finishing. Okay, and prevention in the sense certain mistakes are going to be happen, and that one we need to be reduced by adopting certain tools and techniques as well as the specifications. Then we can take certain necessary precautions for those activities, and then that time we can achieve the better quality system. So here this inspection and test, these two activities are used in the management, depends upon the detection or prevention part. Okay. And then fourth point, it involves measurement, tests, gauges, services against the predetermined standards. So here this inspection, that purely involves the measurement, means how exactly that work is to be carried out with respect to certain dimensions, and then we need to conduct a certain test to make them pass for the further activity or further procedure part. And then it requires certain gauges, means it should achieve that particular limit gauges, and then a proper services, and these all should be against the predetermined standards. Okay, it should finally achieve with respect to final standards. Okay, so this terms comes under in inspection as well as the test plan. Next, so inspection generally, which is the most common method of attaining standardization, uniformity and quality of the workmanship. Okay, so here in the construction part, we need to achieve a proper work from the labors and a proper supply from the proper materials from the suppliers, and then uniformity from the management as well as the sub-authorized organizations. Okay, so here this inspection, that is like what it refers with respect to standardization, and then uniformity with respect to work, and then quality of the workmanship, that is achieved by the skilled laborers. Okay, that is achieved by the skilled laborers. And here inspection, it is an art of controlling the product quality after comparison with the established standards and specifications. So these are most important. It's like we are fixing our own products by comparing that one with the established standards. Means might be you can see so many products which are with a good quality in its works as well as in their proper products. So if you are starting that one with a new product, then you need to compare that one with the already established standards as well as the specifications. So if your product is matching with those standards, then we can say that it's with the 100% quality. That one, it can be achieved by inspection process, and it is a function of quality control. So quality control, you will be studying that one in a further part. So here it's the major function of this quality control, so that how exactly you can monitor each and every as every activities with respect to qualities in construction part. Okay, and then this inspection, if the said item does not fall within the zone of the acceptability, it will be rejected, and corrective measures will be applied to see that the items in the future that conform to specified standards. So in this inspection, how the things will come in the sense, so this inspection will be each and monitored in each and every activities of the construction, and if it's not matching with the certain standards or specifications or proper methods, then that work is going to be straightly rejected. Then after rejection, they are going to suggest for the rejected activity or rejected item or rejected workmanship, then they are going to suggest that one in a proper way. Okay, so again, after taking the corrective measures, we can see that item or product in future, whether it is conforming to the standards or not. Okay, so inspection, which is an indispensable tool of modern manufacturing process, it's nothing but what in modern manufacturing process it is must and should. So because here modern tools and techniques which are difficult to monitor for the current generation, so that time might be they can make any mistakes while monitoring and all. So especially in the manufacturing process, this inspection should be there in each and every part of the construction work. Okay, and it helps to quality controlling the quality and reduces the manufacturing cost, that eliminate the scrap losses and assignable causes of the defective work. So you can see a product which requires certain raw materials at the initial stage, and after the raw material, after the manufacturing process, then it forms a certain product. Okay, so within this particular procedures or stages, it should reduces with the manufacturing cost, so that one you can achieve by the inspection, and then it eliminates the scrap, I mean whatever the wastage can get generated while manufacturing process. So if you have adopted proper inspection in between the activities, then you can easily monitor where exactly the more wastage can get developed and how exactly we can reduce that one, and what about the necessary precautions to reduce that. So each and everything you can get monitored by using this inspection process. Okay, and then whatever losses can get developed and how we can overcome those losses, and certain works which will get causes the defective work at the end product, means at the end product might be the dimensions may get false from the original shape and size, and then might be some cracks may get developed in the certain products, and might be it may get bent with a certain shrinkage. So many defects you can see in its structure. So if you monitor continuously that particular product or that particular work by using this inspection, so no such defects can be visible at the end of the production. Okay, so for that this inspection is must in each and every stage of the manufacturing process as well as the construction works. and the main purpose of this inspection. So why exactly we require this inspection in the construction field? So here the purpose of inspection, what exactly this inspection process will do in the construction activities and why it is required. So first thing, to distinguish between good lots from the bad lots. So here good lots and the bad lots are nothing but in the construction field the materials will come from far away places. So once it reaches to the construction site, we need to separate it out from the entire lots which comes from the far away places. So we need to pick up only good parts and then we need to make it a separate the bad lots. So only we can use the good lots to the construction works so that it can achieve the better quality aspects. So that one it can be achieved by the inspection process. And then to distinguish good pieces from the bad pieces. So here each and every material, every piece we need to examine before using that one in the construction. So in the inspection process, we can separate it out the good pieces from the bad pieces. So bad pieces are purely rejected for the construction work and so it can reduces the quality aspects. So it can be achieved by using this inspection process. And to determine if the process is changing, so by using this inspection we need to determine whether the entire process is changing. Okay, that means what? If any suggestions are taken by the clients and if any bad materials or bad workmanship has been provided for the construction work, so it can get changed by using this inspection. Okay, and to determine if the process is approaching the specification limit. So approaching specification limit, it gives much valid words. That means this specification term that belongs to Indian Standard Code Book. So each and every activities has to be there within this Indian Standard Code Books, and then it should have certain limits, then only it can be used in the construction work. So this particular process can be achieved by the inspection process. And then to rate the quality of product. So this inspection, it can give a certain ratings to the product each and after completion of each and every stages. Okay, so that time it can give certain ideas about the product after completing those procedure part. Okay, and to rate accuracy of the inspectors, so that one also it can be achieved by the inspection. And to measure the precision of measuring instrument. So here this precision of the measuring instruments, so that is the tool, is one that can measure the values in very small increments. For example, a standard ruler that can measure a length to the nearest millimeter. So here it can achieve pin to pin dimensions of the product and then it can give the very accurate results after the inspection process. And to secure the product design information, so the inspection part, it is going to give the brief idea about the entire process since from starting till end, so that you can achieve a better product design information at the starting stage. And then to measure the process capability, so here this process capability, that is nothing but a unique combination of different tools, different materials, methods and people which are engaged in the producing measurable output. So if you want to produce a certain product, so it can measure the requirements such as materials and different tools and various methods and the workmanship carried by the people, those who are engaged in producing a measurable output. And here, for example, a manufacturing line for the machine parts. So here all the processes, they have inherent statistical variability and which can be evaluated by the statistical method. So that's nothing but, so whatever the instruments we are using here, so that one also it can be checked by the inspection process. Okay. And then the different process which involved in the inspection activity. So what process will be there in the inspection and how exactly they are going to monitor the activities by using this inspection process. So first, here listing down the operations which are required for the inspection and test. That means so here list down operations required for inspection and test. So operations are nothing but what exactly the activities are there in the construction work. That one we need to note down, and for each and every activities whatever the inspection procedures are there, so that one we need to monitor. So first we need to note down what are the activities are to be done with the inspection as well as the test plan. Okay, so for that we need to note down all the operations which are required for the inspections, and here after the noting down, prepare the schedule and time for test and inspections. So for that we need to give certain time for those activities, and then we need to start examine those activities after giving certain schedules for them. So in the meantime, the contractors or whatever, whoever are working on those activities are to be ready with those aspects or activities, and then at the time of inspection they have to be produced with all the necessary documents, right? like the materials which are specified under the Indian standards, and then the work procedures as well as the workmanship. So each and everything it has to be monitored and checked by the inspection process, and here indicate the responsibility to conduct test. So we need to conduct certain test on those products or else on those activities, then we can give certain certified certifications on those works, or else even we can give certain ratings for that work. For example, if you want to check the strength of the already constructed road, we want to conduct certain tests there. For example, field dry density and all. So that time we will come to know that the total amount of compaction, that how much it has been done on that, and what about the strength of that material center, and then listing methods to be adopted. So if any suggestions are there, any methods are there, that one also we need to note down. And whenever if that work is rejected by the inspection committee, that time they need to give certain suggestions that they need to carry out the further work like so and so, and then they need to give brief idea about those works, and then they need to help to carry out that one to achieve with 100% of the quality aspects. And then identify the requirements of presence of various people such as skilled people. Means as we discussed in the previous part, we can achieve the 100% quality only by using the skilled people. So we need to examine even by considering these people, those who are carrying out those particular activities. So we need to take certain cross examination on these people so that we will come to know that, I mean those who are there in the inspection committee, they will come to know that whether these people are skilled or not. So they might be, they can ask a few questions like how exactly you are going to carry out this work, which type of materials you are going to consider, what about the proportions, how much you will add the water, and which code books it belongs to, and what about the range of the materials after conducting the test. So each and everything might be they can ask to the skilled people, so they should be able to answer those all questions. So that's the part of this inspection committee. So then only they will believe that yes, these are the skilled laborers, and they will be knowing certain techniques about this work, and then they can carry out the work so that they can achieve with the 100% of the quality works in the construction. So like this, the different process which are involved in the inspection activity.